Good morning, New City Kids, and happy Sunday. I'm so excited to be back here again with you. This week, we are talking about the fruits of the Spirit. And this week's fruit is goodness. So we want to learn all about the fruit of the Spirit, goodness. And when we think about the fruit of the Spirit, goodness, we're actually not thinking about being good. We are talking about doing good. So what are some things that we could do good in our communities? Well, right now, food banks really need donations. They always need donations, but especially during this time of quarantine, there's a lot of people who don't have enough money for the food that they need. So if you go into your cabinets and or you're at the grocery store and you can do some extra shopping of picking up some canned goods and things like peanut butter and tomatoes, paste and beans and salsa, anything that's non-perishable, so that means it can stay well, good for a long time on the shelves. So if you guys can do that, that would be awesome and it would be showing good. What are some other ways that we can show and do good things to our community? What do you think? Those are great ideas. Maybe taking out the trash, maybe helping a neighbor with yard work or pulling weeds. Any of those things would be showing that you are doing good. Well, in the Bible, it tells us that goodness is the fruit of the Spirit. So let's go to the Bible and let's find out what else it tells us about the fruit of the Spirit, goodness. In Psalm 31:19, it says, "Oh, how abundant is your goodness, which you have stored up for those who fear you and worked for those who take refuge in you, in the sight of the children of mankind." Zephaniah 9:16-17 says, "On that day, the Lord God will save them as the flock of his people, for like the jewels of the crown, they shall shine in the land. For how great is his goodness and how great is his beauty." So what do we learn from these two verses? Well, it tells us that if you believe in Jesus, that he died on the cross and saved you from your sins, and you follow him, then God promises his goodness to us. This means that whatever happens in our lives, however horrible or bad it might seem, God ultimately intends for our good. And because he is completely good, it is impossible for him to do anything not good. And when we see and go through really difficult and terrible times, you have to learn and cling to this truth. God is good all the time. And the things we think are intended for our harm, he intends for our good. I always try to remember that God is going to bring good out of whatever situation we're going through. He promises that in these Bible verses. Another Bible verse that I love and always cling to is Galatians 6:9. It says, "And let us not grow weary of doing good, for in due season we will reap if we do not give up." Ephesians 2:10 also says, "For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them." So God not only is good and shows us his goodness, he created us to do good, which is what we were talking about in our object lesson, acts of goodness, where we help others and give to them. Remember that every time you see the canned goods and the peanut butter and the salsa, think about God is calling us to do good. Doing good can actually be difficult and challenging sometimes, but it's also very rewarding. We grow more like Christ and we learn how to be compassionate and loving to the poor and the needy. We experience the love of people that we may never have talked to before. So it's amazing how God shows us his goodness, And it's also amazing how God helps us to do good to others. So you're going to go into the worship songs today. You have one worship song link, and you also have a Bible story link. There are two worship songs in that Bible story link. And you're going to find out what exactly goodness is. And you're going to hear about the apostles or the disciples, the friends of Jesus, and what they did when Jesus left to show good to their community. Now, I want you to remember to go on to the YouVersion Bible app. That's our second challenge. So make sure that you get on there and that you friend me, and we can do some devotions together. This week's devotions are all about worship. And we're going to find out what exactly does worship mean and how does it show up in our lives and what do we have to do and play a part in it. We're also doing our third challenge, which is our Bible verse. This is your last week to get your monthly Bible verse in for the month of May. Next week, we are starting June's Bible verse. So you can send me a video of you doing your Bible verse, or you can call me and you can say your Bible verse to me, or you can have your parents put it in the group chat. So our Bible verse for the month of May is John 14, 27. Let's say it one more time together. John 14, 27. I leave you peace. It is my own peace I give to you. I give you a peace that is different than the world does. So don't be troubled. Don't be afraid. Make sure you send those videos to me. I can't wait to see you guys putting God's word in your heart. Let's go ahead and pray together, okay? Let's close our eyes. Let's think about God who we're talking to. Lord, we thank you so much for this time, this morning that we had together to learn more about your goodness and to learn how we can do good in our communities, in our families, and in our homes. I pray, Lord, that you would help each boy and girl to remember to do good and to remember that it's not on their own, that you are the one who changes us with the Holy Spirit and gives us the power to do good. Thank you, God, for all these things. I pray that you would keep our families safe and healthy in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. All right. Love you guys so much. And I will see you again next week. And I hope I can deliver a special snack or a special candy to you this week. Let me know what your favorites are when you send your video. Bye, guys.